A-18EF Super Hornet, America's answer to advanced air combat. Developed as the United States military's first all-weather fighter and attack aircraft, the F-A-18 Hornet could take on traditional strike applications, including interdiction and close air, without compromising its fighter capabilities. Over the years, the platform has been steadily improved, and in 1999, the F-A-18EF Super Hornet entered service with the United States Navy as a replacement for the F-14 Tomcat. The F-14 Tomcat was a twin-engine, two-seat fighter aircraft that served in the U.S. Navy from the 1970s until its retirement in 2006. It was primarily used for air superiority and fleet defense missions. The second upgrade of the F-A-18 model, the F-A-18EF Super Hornet, was highly capable and versatile across a full range of missions. It was capable of performing multiple roles such as air superiority, fighter escort, reconnaissance, aerial refueling, air defense suppression, and day-night precision strikes. The Super Hornet is currently manufactured by Boeing following its merger with McDonnell Douglas in 1997 and is available in two distinct versions, the single-seat F-A-18E and the dual-seat F-A-18F. The aircraft is powered by two F-14 GE400 turbofan engines, which are capable of producing a combined thrust of 44,000 pounds. To maximize airflow into the engines, the air inlets have been enlarged. With afterburner engaged, its engines can provide a maximum speed in excess of Mach 1.8. The first operational use of the F-A-18E was with Strike Fighter Squadron 115, known as the Eagles, which was operating from the USS Abraham Lincoln on July 24, 2002. The aircraft saw its first combat action on November 6th of the same year, when the squadron took part in enforcing a no-fly zone in Iraq. The F-A-18EF was also deployed as part of Operation Iraqi Freedom in March 2003. Warfighting ready. Its capability and reliability as an aircraft have been well established. The Super Hornet is a multi-role attack aircraft that can perform a variety of missions with the use of different external equipment. Its advanced networking capabilities allow it to accomplish very specific missions, making it a valuable force multiplier when deployed to meet the challenges a carrier might face. The F-A-18EF Super Hornet has proven to be a highly versatile aircraft, thanks in part to its impressive armament capabilities. With a total of 11 weapon stations, including two wing store stations, this fighter jet is capable of carrying a wide range of armaments to meet various mission requirements. In terms of air-to-air missiles, the Super Hornet can carry the AIM-9 Sidewinder, AIM-7 Sparrow, and AIM-120 AMRAAM. It's also equipped with guided air-to-ground weapons like the AGM-84 SLAM-ER Standoff Land Attack Missile Expanded Response, Paveway series of laser-guided bombs, AGM-88 HARM, High-Speed Anti-Radiation Missile, AGM-154 JSOW, Joint Standoff Weapon, and AGM-65 Maverick. Anti-ship missiles such as Harpoon and AGM-158C LRASM, and free-fall air-to-ground bombs, Mark 80 series unguided bombs, JDAMs, and Mark 62, 63, 65 quick-strike naval mine. In addition to its impressive range of external armament, the F-A-18EF Super Hornet is armed with an internal weapon that packs a serious punch. The General Dynamics M61A2 20mm Gatling-style gun is a hydraulically driven, six-barreled rotary-action weapon that uses electric firing to deliver devastating firepower at a selectable rate of either 4,000 or 6,000 rounds per minute. This high rate of fire allows the gun to rapidly exchange targets at short range, making it an essential tool for close air support and air-to-air combat situations. Expanding on strengths. Since its introduction in 2001, the F-A-18EF Block II Super Hornet, which incorporates a number of technologies that enhance its capabilities, has earned a reputation as the backbone of the Navy's carrier air wing. The production of Block II aircraft concluded in April 2020 with the delivery of the final 322E and 286F models. A month after that, the first pair of F-A-18 Block III test jets were sent to the Navy for carrier testing. Boeing developed the Block 3 Super Hornet to complement current and future air wing capabilities, while the Navy plans to use the aircraft to test and explore new operational concepts. The first Block 3 aircraft featured several advancements, including an advanced cockpit system with a 10-inch by 19-inch touchscreen display that functions like a large tablet. The system replaced many traditional cockpit buttons and knobs and enabled pilots to track and target multiple long-range objects with greater precision. The aircraft also have the Open Architecture Distributed Targeting Processor Network, DTPN, which gives the aircraft's mission computer more processing power and networking capability, as well as the Tactical Targeting Network Technology, TTNT, data link. Block 3 Super Hornets have certain features to help reduce the jet's radar signature as well. Beyond all that, this program has rolled in two other updates that had previously been in the works for future Navy Super Hornets, these being an improved satellite communication, SATCOM system, and the integration of a Potted Infrared Search and Track, IRST, system. The IRST is a stealth equalizer that provides the ability to passively detect and counter stealthy aircraft such as Russia's Sukhoi Su-57 5th-generation fighter and China's 5th-generation fighters, including the Chengdu J-20 and the Shenyang FC-31. Extending the airframe life of the Super Hornet is a Navy priority. The FA-18EF has a 6,000-hour service life, but the strike fighter's been used heavily over nearly 20 years of conflict in Iraq, Afghanistan, and Syria. That's worn out significant numbers of Super Hornets, leading to lower readiness rates and leaving some examples with little useful life remaining. New build Block 3 Super Hornets will have an airframe service life of 10,000 hours. Block 2 Super Hornets receiving Block 3 modifications will get an additional 4,000 hours of service life per jet. Furthermore, the Block 3 Super Hornet was set to feature shoulder-mounted conformal fuel tanks. They could carry 3,500 pounds of additional fuel and reduce drag, allowing the aircraft to operate longer, go faster, and/or carry more weight. This option's been dropped, however. The hardware upgrades are complete. Today, we're maximizing the open hardware and software and developing the apps to keep the Block 3 ahead of future threats. Jen Thibault, Boeing's Vice President of FA-18 and EA-18G programs, said in a press release regarding the delivery of the first operational upgraded jets, "We're giving Navy pilots the tools to make the fastest and most informed decisions possible now and in the future." The end of the journey. After nearly a decade of fits and starts, the Navy has quietly initiated work to develop its first new carrier-based fighter in almost 20 years, standing up a new program office and holding early discussions with industry, U.S. Military News has learned. The multi-billion dollar effort to replace the FA-18EF Super Hornet, beginning in the 2030s, is taking early steps to quickly develop a new manned fighter to extend the reach of the carrier air wing and bring new relevance to the Navy's fleet of nuclear-powered aircraft carriers. Navy Acquisition Chief James Gertz told reporters last week that the service created a program office for the Next Generation Air Dominance Initiative. "We're working to outline that program and the acquisition approach and all that as we speak," Gertz said. Naval Air Systems Command's recent establishment of the NGAD program office comes as the Pentagon faces a constrained budget environment while trying to adjust to a new defense strategy focused on combating Russian and Chinese threats in the Indo-Pacific theater. The service is likely moving toward the pursuit of a manned fighter aircraft that would include many of the capabilities of the F-35C Lightning II Joint Strike Fighter, but with updated technology and expanded range. Brian Clark, a naval analyst and senior fellow with the Hudson Institute. To kick off the NGAD initiative, the Navy formally stood up the Next Generation Air Dominance Program Office, which the service is calling PMA 230, in May, and tapped Captain Al Masseau to serve as the program manager. However, Masseau has since retired and has been succeeded by Captain John Doherty. Despite the move towards a new fighter aircraft, the Super Hornet will continue to play a critical role for the Navy in the coming years. The FA-18EF will remain the primary strike power from U.S. carriers for the next decade, offering a versatile and reliable platform for a wide range of missions.